name is Aaron, and this is the first episode of The Daily at Lincoln, a news review, music review, any kind of thing, all thrown into the mix, put into a cake and baked for you here on The Daily at Lincoln. It is March 8th, 2022, and this is your edition. Today we're going to be talking about Elden Ring, a PC review coming up here. Additionally, maybe some music mixed in there for good measure to talk about all kinds of good stuff in the mixture out there in the world. Some news, some weather, and a little bit more all here on Creative Morgan's The Daily at Lincoln. Hey, today is March 8th, 2022. We obviously record these the day before, and then we throw them out into the world. Today on the docket, on the list, on the requisite conversation piece for this segment of The Daily at Lincoln is The Elden Ring, which is a game that just recently came out from Software, which is the guys who have produced the Dark Souls series.
Dark Souls, yeah.
Dead Souls, Dark Souls, same difference. You die in those games a lot. Yeah. And so they've produced the Dark Souls series. They've created Sekiro Die Twice. They have done a lot of work in this industry, in this game series. And so myself and Dorian, hilariously enough, both own this game. I think Dorian's probably played a little bit more of it than I have.
Yeah.
And I tend to use trainers and cheats sometimes because From Software games are notoriously hard.
Yeah.
And they make it challenging. So talk to us about what it was like kind of doing your playthrough.
I'm not even done yet.
Tell me how it started, I guess.
So it started pretty easily. So I started as a samurai character because it looked cool.
Because it looked cool. Yeah. None of the actual tactical work went into it. Okay. All right. Good talk.
I got a cool sword. Got a cool outfit.
Okay.
Well, actually, so there's with the samurai starting off character, you get an apparently, it's one of the best starting characters.
Okay.
Besides the mage.
Pull your microphone closer to your face, sir.
All right. Apparently, there it is. There we go. Characters besides the mage because of the bleed stack from the sword.
Okay.
Which does really good damage against what's it called?
Like the big bosses or whatever.
Yeah. The ones that are susceptible to bleed.
Oh, okay.
Take a big damage.
Oh, okay.
It takes out a chunk of their health.
All right. So how far along have you gotten so far with the playthrough?
I'm going to be real with you. I've been stuck on a boss for like 5 hours.
So if you're listening to this and you're wondering, well, that's crazy. Why would that? If you've never played Dark Souls or Dark Souls 1, 2, 3 or any of the From Software games, this game has the tag on Steam attached to it that says Souls-like. And so it has a lot of the infrastructure from the Dark Souls game series. And one of that pieces of that infrastructure is you have to be leveled up to be able to take on these bosses. You have to have your potions. You got to have your stuff. You got to have your weapons. So when you get out of the game in the first round, there's a guy on a horse. And if you try and fight him, you're dead. You're not going to make it. So you have to literally go into every single cavern and cave and go around him to buff up your experience and get your strength. Your runes, if you will.
Yeah.
And so when you're hearing Dorian say, dude, you're stuck on 5 hours on a boss, that's part of the struggle is that once you enter into that fight, you're in the fight and you got to figure out a way to get him down. Eventually you do, mostly.
My problem is that, so my multiplayer is messed up somehow. It's my fault because I've messed with my internet and it's not working at the moment.
Oh, so you can't even get help.
Yeah, so it's actually... So it's to the point where the game itself on the boss room provides its own NPC. So
the game's like you clearly are out of your depth, Dorian.
It automatically provides an NPC, but I can't activate it for some reason either. So I'm by myself in an area where the game itself recommends
all
an NPC.
All by myself.
Yeah.
Okay. And, all right. So that sucks.
Yeah.
That's no fun. Okay, so what is it about Elden Ring that made you want to... I mean, it's not a cheap game. It's like, what, 50, 60 bucks. What made you want to buy Elden Ring? What was the thing that said, yep, that's what I want to play?
I actually didn't buy it.
Oh, how did you get it?
So on PlayStation, there's a game share.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's how I have it. But I would have bought it if my friend didn't buy it. I definitely would have bought it.
Okay.
I just like hard games like that.
Yeah.
It's you put a lot of time into them.
Mm-hmm.
And it's sometimes you feel like you got something out of it, but other times you
okay.
I don't know. It's just fun.
Nice. You know, here's the thing about computer games, and we've talked about this on the Computer Gaming Podcast with Chris. So, like, if a game's not fun, you don't want to play it. And it sounds really like elementary and like, oh, okay, whatever. But it's true. If it's too hard, or if it's too much management, or whatever, it, like if the game just is asking you to do so much that you no longer enjoy playing it, like that's a bad game design. That's badly mechanicked. But with Elden Ring, yeah, no, it's, first of all, it's a beautifully, beautiful game.
It's one of the best looking Souls-like games I've ever seen.
It is incredible. And every environment you go into is different. Mm-hmm. They didn't cut and paste and copy and paste dungeons and stuff. They designed it from scratch.
Yeah, I am really enjoying the open world because I can actually run away from enemies I can't fight yet.
Run away! Yeah, no, I do that too. I have, like, even with my trainers and my cheats that I use, I'm like, I don't want to fight him right now. I want to go explore and, like, pick up all my runes and, like, beat. You can take on, like they call them bullet sponges in other, like, first person shooter games where that's how you get your experience, is you attack all the low end kind of guys. Yeah. So yeah, it's a fun game. Elden Ring, there's been some port issues, but they've been having some updates on the PC. You have to play it with a controller. You can't play with a keyboard. I tried.
Oh, do you?
Oh, God, no. I tried with a keyboard, and it doesn't make any sense. So I had to pick up an Xbox controller, and it actually feels a lot better using a controller. So you can't play it. You can play with a keyboard, but the map key is G. I don't understand that at all.
Dang.
And, like, crouch is, like, 5.3. I don't know. It's nuts.
I actually keep on... I keep on messing up my crouch. Uh-huh. So when I'm trying to sneak behind an enemy, I actually sprint and jump at them. So,
you're like, gosh dang it.
Funny story. Yeah. I was walking through a forest and I jumped at a bear.
Okay.
So.
And you had to fight the bear now because you couldn't sneak up on him.
No, he killed me.
Oh, he killed you.
Yeah.
And the Souls games are always like, there's no mercy. It's just like, you died.
Yep.
And you're like, man, I feel like such a failure. And then you go back at it and you go until you can win. All right. Well, Dorian, 10 out of 10, what would you rate so far your experience with Elden Ring?
Definitely 10 out of 10. It's an amazing game.
Yeah. And look, Dorian plays a lot of games. Like, this dude is not just like some like little, oh, I'm a newbie. I'm just playing. No, Dorian has put time in. He plays, what else do you play?
I take too long to list them out.
Give a short list, sir.
Destiny 2, Neo, yeah. Minecraft.
Yep.
Destiny 1 sometimes.
Yep.
Neo 1.
Yep.
What was the other one?
Mm.
That one game that they made, that's a studio that made Elden Ring made.
Oh, Sekiro Die Twice?
Yes.
Yes.
That one.
I have not played, but I have watched the playthroughs of that thing, and it makes me want to buy the game. Because I'm just like, that is insane. Like, it's so intricate, and the storyline is so connected.
I would say this right now, it's harder.
harder than this? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, then I'm going to have to use a lot of trainers to get through Sekiro.
Or maybe I'm just bad at it.
No, I think you're probably good. I think it's just they do make those games really hard. Well, that has been the first segment of the first episode of The Daily at Lincoln. Thank you for reviewing with me Elden Ring. And that's this part. We'll go on to another segment, and this will be your first daily podcast and all that kind of stuff. So stick around, hold on, jump in, strap in, put on your seatbelts, and I don't know, put your hands and feet inside the ride at all times. We'll move on to the next segment here on The Daily at Lincoln. Thank you, Dorian.
All right.
Next, we're going to be talking about Weird Al Yankovic, and a student is going to join me who has no idea who Weird Al is. So hold on, buckle up, strap in. Here we go with some Weird Al. All right, so Weird Al Yankovic, you'll have to put on your headphones there, Thomas. Yeah. Thomas is joining. He is our county computer host from our podcast class. And he is coming in as kind of a newbie, a new person of the Weird Al experience. Weird Al Yankovic has been around for a long time. He was around when I was in middle school, which was in 1997, which is a long time ago for those of you who are calculating this on the home game. Actually, I'll do the math for you right now because I can't do it in my head.
25.
Thanks for that. Yes, 25 years ago. Thank you. 25 years ago, Weird Al was...
Brush the dust off that one.
get the anti-rust spray, go to Walmart and buy the CRM or whatever it is.
Just get some Croil.
Get some Croil. Great. Thanks. I'm old. Moving on. So Weird Al has been around for a long time, and he does parody music. So he's made parodies of just about everything that you can imagine. Michael Jackson, he's made parodies of everybody, United States of America, the whole nine yards. Weird Al has done it. And he's done it without any controversy, without any, like, oh my gosh, Weird Al, he did this horrible thing and we're tracking on him now and stuff like that. Yes?
I think I need boost because I'm really quiet.
No,
I
you're good.
You're loud.
I know, and so are you. You're good. Huh. You may just not hear yourself in your headphones.
Strange. Okay, continue.
We're on the fly. We're flying by the seat of our pants on this podcast. So, anyway, Weird Al also... So, Weird Al's coming to town. He's coming to Denver. I'm sorry.
Denver.
And he has two kinds of songs that he's done. The first set of songs are his parodies, you know, the Anakin song, which is long, long time from the old, like, 60s song. And then he made a new one about Anakin and Star Wars and everything else. And he also has a bunch of songs that are not parodies, which are songs that he just writes because he can. If you want to, Google Albuquerque, the song by Weird Al. Albuquerque is a song that is at least 8 minutes long. Song by Weird Al Yankovic. It is... Let's see how long it is. We're going to get a sample of it here in a second.
King Supers.
No, I don't want King Supers ads. But the song itself, which I'm going to try and get it to do here, is a polka song that is like... I'm waiting for ads on YouTube, which is really disappointing. There we go. It is 11 minutes long.
Wow.
It's 11 minutes long, and it kind of goes a little bit like this.
Way back when I was just a little bitty boy, living in a box under the stairs in the corner of the basement of the house half a block down the street from Jerry's bait shop. You know the place.
Okay, so that's a sample.
That's oddly specific.
That whole song, it's 11 minutes and 22 seconds of just like strain of consciousness writing of a song. And it is my favorite song of Weird Al of all time, because it basically tells us a loose story of this guy who hates sauerkraut because his mom gave it to him for breakfast every single day of his life until he turned 18, and then he left and he married a girl and they had all these wonderful things, and then she said, you should get a Columbia Record Collection Club, and he flips out and says, no, I can't do it, and then he runs and adventures and things happen and it comes to the end and it's fantastic.
So these have got to be the longest lyrics.
Yes. Oh no, it's insanity.
Look.
Yeah, it's pages. Pages.
It's literally pages.
Pages of Albuquerque. It is fantastic. On YouTube, there's actually someone made a video.
I want to get the word count here.
Hold just on. Weird Al Yankovic Albuquerque the movie. It's a Flash movie that he made, and it has 3.5 million views, and it is fantastic. It's just you, like, there's certain parts of the song that I can recite as he's singing them, but the chorus goes, Albuquerque, and it's brilliant. As a 14-year-old kid, or however old I was when the song came out, like, this was just like so certain people loved Kurt Cobain and Nirvana and that hard edge kind of like grunge. I loved Weird Al. I was a big old nerd. And
so
I,
the word count.
Yeah, how's that? What's our word count?
1,811, and the character count is 1,213. Or the character count is 9,213. Yeah.
So Weird Al's coming to town. He's coming to Denver in the beginning of June, and I have got tickets to both days because I was like, I'm a big old nerd, and I got to go. And so the concert is for all the songs that are not parodies. They're all his self-written,
I wonder
self-made.
If he's going to play the same music on both days.
No. That's why I got my tickets for 2 days.
Hey, look at that.
So I researched, and he's like, yeah, if I'm in town for 2 days, I'm not going to play the same music twice. I'm going to play different music one night and different music the next night. I was like, oh my gosh.
Some of these shows are already sold out.
Uh-huh. That's why I got after it, because it was like, oh my gosh. So that's your Weird Al prep. If you're out there in the world today and you're like, I did not know that Weird Al was touring, you should go and Google Weird Al Tour, find the information, lock in it, get involved, and discover the power of Weird Al to change your life. And if you don't listen to Weird Al right now, you need to obviously put the pause button on this podcast, go over to your Spotify, iTunes, whatever service you use, Pandora, and open up.
Well, you can't really choose what music you want to listen to on Pandora.
Okay, well, it was a metaphor, Thomas. Okay, like, come on. I was just trying, and then you ruined my vibe, to borrow your the kids' terms. You killed the vibe, Thomas.
Sorry, that's my bad.
How dare you? You're fired. And then rehired for the next time we do this. Okay, well, that's been your Weird Al prep. Go out and explore the Weird Al madness. There is a bunch of fun. Enjoy, and yeah, thanks, Thomas, for hanging out and making me feel old and stupid.
This has been very interesting.
That's not the first time it's been said about any experience with me. On to the next thing. You've been listening to The Daily at Lincoln, our daily podcast where we sometimes cover the news, entertainment, games, music, and more from our studio here in Fort Morgan, Colorado, at Lincoln High School in Morgan County. Have something you think we need to cover? Email us at adelayedteacher@gmail.com. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you in the next episode.